Good afternoon. My name is Derek, and today I'd like to present you about my thesis, is that from science fiction to reality, a deep dive into smart home and adoption through the lens of cognitive, affective, and behavioral variables. This is my agenda. I have the introduction, literature review, conceptual framework, hypothesis, data and methodologies, resource contributions, limit and future research directions. This is me. My name is Greg. We are here. I'm head of the technology solutions. I am head of the technology solution of SASF. And I have the background experience in the software engineer. I have been working for Thomson Reuters and other companies. Okay, this is my introduction. This is the chart showing the growth of the IoT technologies and device. It's the incremental growth. And digital technologies such as the Internet of Things, AI, artificial intelligence are crucial in transforming numbers of the industry. The utilization of the smart technology in the evolving, adopting to innovation, to shifting customer behaviors and demand, include the trend of the smart home in Bangkok and other sites of worldwide. I would like to show you the background about my company. My company is named SASF. We are the leader of the real estate in Thailand. We are number one in the luxury home. We dominate market in the luxury home, and we treat ourselves as the top tech. And 5 years ago, we tried to transform ourselves. We don't want to sell, to build a house and convenience and sales to the customer. We transform ourselves to living solutions provider. We would like to give the solutions for the living to our customer. That's why we focus on the property tax. And we are prominent property development in Thailand. Despite those advancements, there are already barriers to widespread acceptance and the future development of the smart homes. The purpose of this study to examine the influence of the technology acceptance of the smart home. I have the two main questions. The first, which features or benefits of the smart home create value in kid well-being, and finally, favorable smart home adoptions, and second, with the features or barriers of smart home destroy, value decrease well-being, and finally, higher smart home adoptions. This is my literature review. I use many literature review, but I focus on UTA, UT2. For the literature review, we developed and extended UTA, UT2, the social recognition theory, the hedonic motivation system adoption theories, the use and gratification theory, the theory of the transformative consumer research, and final trust leaks and theory. This is my conceptual framework. I try to extend UTA, UT2 as I told the last slide. It's helping by using the smartphone user in Bangkok to our best knowledge. This research is the first research that explores in the smartphone users context. Based on our results, we conclude that intentions to use the real users of the smartphone are based on both retention utilities, prevention-oriented, and effective promotion-oriented, driving motivations. This is my data and methodologies. I used the online survey in the April of July 2022. The populations I surveyed with 219 existing smart home users for SASF. When we sell the home, we bundle the IoT technology in the home to them. And we use the measurement in the adapting for the 5-point Likert scale.
No.
And the methodology, we use the CB, SEM. structured equations modeling by Jamovi software. By the way, we try to use the smart in PRS. It's the same result. It's the, luckily, it's the same result. Yes, this is my result. Our model is show that there are seven hypotheses from that are significant, and I found that this study explored contextual perspective of the our extend UTA UT2 theory using the real smartphone user for SCSF residents. The research showed that there is positive impact of the high effort dependency on the performance expectations. It's you can see the H2A is the related, and furthermore, the higher habit of users is H5. And subject well, subjective well-being in the H7 lead to the high intentions of intention to use smart home, which in turn lead higher real user smart home in the H8. And moreover, high hedonic motivation in the H9, and technically trust positive impact the well-being of the resident in H10. In contrast, higher technology risk navigatory impact to technology task of the smart home user in the H11B. This result questions is tested empirical of the first time worldwide with the real smart home user, and it's not only fiction scenario. We do not turn on the video and get the user to see the video or give the mockup to them. We test with the real user. They live in their home with the automation, with the home automation and the smart home. Yes. This increases the reality of the results as disruptive technology was perceived as tangible. This is my contributions for the theoretical contributions. The first is partially confirmed of the UTA, UT2, and show that EE directive and positive effects to the PE is the reference from the Professor Van Christian Davis. In the line with the regulatory theory, confirm of the utilitarian of the conventions oriented part that run from the perceived technology secure to BI of the smart home. Confirm of the promotion oriented part that runs from TT that positively influence to subjective well-being to decrease the perceived risks, which have a positive effect to the BU, and can be confirmed that transformative marketing theory is by showing the subject well-being, HM and TT, significant to drive the BI to use the smartphone and new uses. Yes, this is the final contribute for the methodologies. The contribute to understand the smart home, this can be adoption based on the real user experience to gain the realistic view of the smart home adoption, which has never been done in the research about the smart home. This is my contribution to the real world for the manager and the marketing, focus on the customer well-being because they're interesting about the well-being. They don't want to concern. They would like to live in the home. It's like home to protect them and to take care of them. And they don't worry to about the home. And sometimes they forgot to turn off the light, forgot to turn on the security system. I think the smart IoT can be useful for them. This can be help them. And so that when I in the Luxembourg and I have the house in the Thailand, I can monitoring my home by the mobile applications. And I can turn on the security system, turn off the security system. When the postman take the parcel to my home, I can open the door to them and anything like that. And prioritize well-being when design the smart home to make it enhance their daily life. Simplify tasks, quality of life, and is concerned related is quality as well. The final enchant the security and reliability of the smart home system and implement robust security technology to prevent any unauthorized data sharing or the leakage. This is a contribute to the government entitled and policy makers promote the smart home adoption to raising awareness about benefit of the smart home in improve physical and mental well-being, provide the financial. I think it would be good if they can help us to provide financial incentive grant or subsidy to encourage the homeowner in Thailand to adopt the smart home this year. And the finally is they should facilitate partnership and knowledge sharing between industry players, research, and regulatory bodies. My contribution to the social contributes for the smart home providers. UN sustainable goal, the first is the goal 11, sustainable city and the communities. We can adopt home automation to the main facility in the village and can widespread to some country, some town. And goal 7 is the affordable to clean energies, because if you use the home automation, you can check everything in your home. You can, in the future, you can use the AI to control the home for the energies, for the reduced air conditions or increase the air condition automatically. This is the final contribution. This is the goal 3 for the good health and well-being. Through smart home application, management and policy maker should emphasize and communication on communities management topic to use the technology as the communications medium among stakeholder, it's like the customer, employees, partners, politicians, and the communities. And this is a limitation of the future and my future research directions. The limitation is I just only test for the user of the smart home. That it would be great if I can test with the non-user of the smart home. Study should also be done in the other less developed country in Thailand. Right now, I test in the Bangkok only because the CSF sells the house in the Bangkok only. And should add the more longitudinal living experience study should be done. Cross culture study should be done. Future research be developed to explore the benefits and norm of the younger people, because C generations, they do not have too much money to buy the luxury home. And the finally is the future research that should test with the user purchasing powers, the price, and its impact on the smart home or not. It's done for me.
Thank you very much for giving your time. Now is the time for your first rapporteur to speak. So,